clarity and height between these two super heavyweights. The opening bell sounds then. As well as championship gold, the winner of the super heavyweight final will progress through to Rio 2016. As the only qualifier from the super heavyweight division, only one quota place available here in Baku. Being contested between boxers Italy and Ireland. The man wearing blue is the Italian representative, Guido Vianello, 6 feet 6 inches tall, 28 years of age. Permanent. Dean Gardner from Italy. Dean Gardner from Ireland. And goes around the corner right. Inside, longer arms, longer reach of Vianello. All about timing. Vianello electing to turn southpaw. He's walking onto the right hand. He took one to the ribcage there. A few punches to the body of Gardner from Vianello. Mixing badly with that right hand. Gardner did turn to meet it effectively. Vianello still walk about across the ring. Not sure he wasn't made to pay as the referee was speaking to Gardner about keeping his head cut. He's a 10-second lap up. Very good punches to the body from Vianello. Vianello catching. Once again, just on the right hand, he doesn't even turn two good rolo punches underneath to the body of Gardner. Explosive finish to the round upon hearing the 10-second clap, almost a Pavlovian response from Vianello. So get busy and let his hands go. Right flank. Right hand to the body once again from Gardner. Targeted the torso well. heavy to work in the West Church range like that. The most impactful of the individual one two combinations. Julian Jeremy is going from being another really good company. Pop behind that one. The only left hand find that special big right up because once again the partner was right to it. Partner needs to work away there if he hopes to get back onto them. Remember, he can still be open around 10-9 on about 4-2. Second round in succession, it is 10-9 across the board in favor of Guido Dianello. Dean Gordon is going to have to go for broke. So to the third and final round then, the gold medal bout in the super heavyweight division here at the Global Olympic Qualification Tournament in Baku. The man here is blue, the take of the opening two rounds across the board, and unanimity in the scoring. But the three judges using the 10-point run system, good right hand to the body from Dianello. He surely needs to be more urgency, more activity. Frenetic activity in the hat. From the blood from Gardner. Conceded in the two rounds, 10-9. Trail 20-18 on all three scorecards. But of course, remember, these are super heavyweight boxers, the biggest boxers in AIBA Open Boxing. Changing jab with a good jab and then pivot off to the left from the Allen to avoid the counter. But that's super heavyweights. One punch can turn everything around in Dianello. Fires out too many more ponderous right hands like that. Could find himself countered in an instant. Rodney's got to be alert to those types of opportunities. He made the man miss, but wasn't able to get his position to make him pay. Couple of occasions, Dianello was poured out really ponderous right hand. Strong to position himself to land a shot at what would invariably be an unprotected chip. Around the corner with a left hook. A good two shots on the inside from Rodney, but he needs more of that. And this is where he needs to work. Dianello put an awful lot into the opening two rounds. He's beyond the midpoint of the third and final round. His gas tank beginning to deplete, it most certainly is. He's disengaging here, keeping the distance. Gardner's got to close that gap and get busy. In pursuit of his man, but can he get inside? He needs to launch waves of attack. Dianello with a quick burst of activity. Good left jab from Gardner, but it needs to be more from his point of view. He hopes to join his teammates in Rio 2016. The final minute now. Good 1-2 from Dianello. He's desperately tired up there in the boxing ring. And he's managing to maintain a poker face. Phlegmatic expression. Gardner trying to close the distance, but not pulling the trigger. Single shot to the body. Good one, Gardner. Burst of activity once again. inside the final 30 seconds now. Rod Nuts requires a miracle punch now to turn this around in his favor. Good right hand to the body from Rod Nuts. Everybody responds from Gianello. Gianello getting busy on the first foot in the closing stages. Gianello with his back to the ropes. Gardner trying to take advantage. Gardner raising his right hand. Two men exchange pleasantries. Right there, opposite corner. Always nice to see, but one suspects is this man. He's going through to the Olympic tournament. He led by 2 points after two completed rounds of boxing. Gardner went in pursuit of his man, but he was met by a burst of activity on occasion from Guido Gianello. Had a friendly cut around the face with the left hand from Francesco Damiani. They feel his job done. This boxer disagrees with that prevailing move in the blue corner. And both boxers have to stand to ring. Let's get the official verdict. Guido Gianello lets out a roar of delight. He has his hand raised in victory and is being crowned as the gold medalist here at the Global Olympic Qualification Tournament in Baku, Azerbaijan. And most importantly, it means that he is the sole super heavyweight to progress from the global qualifier here in Baku to the Olympic Games of Rio 2016. Wonderful performance by Gianello. He's determined, he's full of activity. And despite Gardner taking the third and final round, the two-round advantage, Gianello had built by taking rounds one and two enough to remove the line as a unanimous point decision victor. 29 points to 28 across the board in favor of the 6'6" Guido Gianello of Italy, who goes through to Rio 2016, and Gardner will come away. Championship silver, and no possible hope of going through to Rio now because he hasn't completed the required number of World Series boxing bouts or any AIBA professional boxing bouts that would enable him to go through to Venezuela at that qualifying point in the world. So that's an example of the type of activity Gianello was able to